And welcome back.
To F.A.T.E.
Okay, so they using Yule Steed.
Yes.
What do we have battery wise? Okay.
Best name.
Yeah, you're good. Don't, you're halfway.
We don't want it to die on us, so that's good.
You get up to the bridge and you notice that there you can just do you need the player's handbook? For Ranger things? Alright. The dirt road that you kind of follow up there, kind of like when you land, clings to the side of a mountain and ends before an arcing bridge of mold-encrusted stone that spans a natural chasm. Gargoyles cloaked in black moss perch on the corners of the bridge, their frowns weather-worn. On the mountainous side of the bridge, a waterfall spills into a misty pool nearly 1,000 feet below, where you came from, essentially. The pool feeds a river that meanders into the fog-shrouded pines that blanket the valley.
I know the seer said that she hadn't met my brother, but I kind of want to perceive and see if I notice.
We're in a whole different world.
I'm kind of curious.
Oh. Okay.
This is Captain
RTM. And no, I don't think so. He could have fallen into a trap.
Give me a,
Nat 20.
Nice. Huh. There's nothing on the bridge.
Okay. Just checking. I just wanted to
But you do notice when you're kind of looking at it that the gargoyles here are just regular gargoyles. They're not like the creature type or anything.
Damn. I'm in for the battle.
Good.
Yeah. I was getting nervous. I thought there was going to be retribution.
No.
Did you guys fight a lot of gargoyles?
Actually, though,
I don't want to fight anything. I don't know. That was bad. That was all right, bad. Cool.
Alrighty. So you continue down if you want
to
move.
I just want to talk to the guy about wine.
Alright, so we are...
What's a dank
for an H.
I need this card. Where'd that card go?
Oh, okay. Someone ran to Shiloh.
Well, yeah, he's GPSing.
Yeah.
That bastard.
He puts his GPS coordinates out there, and you can just go hang out.
I said we can only do four.
You can go four hexes.
Four hexes per little. Roll, yeah. So you've reached four?
I would totally go hang out with you over there.
I would too.
Hang on.
What a howling.
Got
so.
It. Okay. We're going to continue. Yep.
Alright, so the next one puts us on I.
You reach I. Okay.
That is.
You're black, traveling down now. The mist is still pretty heavy.
It's so nice of that seer to even give us a key for our map. How can you
even? Well, it just happens to be.
Well, that's called a map.
How nice
even,
of that seer.
Even here, in the mountains, the forest and the fog are inescapable. Ahead, the dirt road splits into two, widening toward the east. East, that way.
That's backwards.
There you see patches of cobblestone, suggesting that the eastern branch was once an important thoroughfare.
It
stops.
It's not there yet.
It's kind of funny.
Parked at the fork in the road, pointed east, is a large black carriage drawn by two black horses. The horses snort puffs of steamy breath into the chill mountain air. The side door of the carriage swings open silently.
That's freaking creepy. This isn't good.
Riding a flaming horse.
Dude, this whole place has like got me on edge.
So was it an abandoned carriage? I missed it.
There's no one inside the carriage.
Loot. Look to loot the carriage.
Okay. I don't want to go near that carriage.
Yeah, go, Ems. Go. I think it's a bad idea, but I'm not stopping you.
What's the worst that can happen?
A lot of things.
It was his final words.
famous last words. Can't get it wrong.
You also see, I'm a bear. Heading west, there is a set of iron gates.
Are they closed?
They are currently closed right now, yes.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Sure. You're not a wolf, Katie.
So...
Decisions.
So we can't really get through.
We can't get through it.
Well, you haven't approached the gates yet. So you don't know what happened.
We have a horse that flies.
Emsh.
We just fly over every obstacle.
Emsh, fly towards the gates.
Let's just ride the carriage. It's already got horses.
Yeah, it's... I can't metagame. I don't know where it's going to.
Could speed up time.
Well, you know, because you have the map, that east of your location is Castle Ravenloft.
Oh, man, we probably don't want to go
where the Devil Strahd
lives. Where the Devil Strahd lives.
Well, unlives.
Unlives.
West it is.
That's funny.
This is going.
All right, well, let's go inspect those gates then.
Okay.
Anybody want to do that?
Yeah.
Let's get a pussyfoot around here.
As you approach the gates, I have information on that. Here we go. The fog spills out of the forest to swallow up the road behind you. Ahead, jutting from the impenetrable woods on both sides of the road, are high stone buttresses looming gray in the fog. Huge iron gates hang on the stonework. Dew clings with cold tenacity to the rusted bars. Two headless statues of armed guardians flank the gate, their heads now lying among the weeds at their feet. They greet you only in silence.
God damn it.
Hello to you too.
God, it reminds me of the never-ending story of what happens.
That's good. As you approach,
go.
As you get within, I'd say probably like 40 or 50 feet of the gate, they swing open with very loud creaking.
It's convenient.
Also dang creepy.
Yeah, it's pretty loud.
We just need to accept that this place is just creepy as fuck and...
No, it is creepy.
Move on.
But I've heard stories of gates like this. Sometimes if you just go through it like you own the place, you're good.
So what do you do?
I go through it like I own the place. Why not?
Right.
Riding my flaming horse. I mean, what else are we going to do, guys? Why are we just hanging out?
Is everybody going?
Yeah, I'm going through the gate.
What kind of adventurers are we? We're just going to be afraid of that
creepy green carriage.
As you get about, 40 or 50 feet away down the road, the gate will slam shut behind you.
When lightning strikes us, somewhere we're all dead. Game over, guys.
All right, continue. Every four. Let me know.
All we have to do is walk through the gate.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. We're at a crossroads.
No, we're at a fork.
Okay.
Oh.
Is there a...
Old bone grinder.
Old bone grinder.
That's the mill.
Cool, all right. Hang on.
We're at the fork, though.
Yeah, we're not quite at it
yet. We're not at it.
No, this is good. This is good stuff.
Thank God we stopped at the fork instead of after the fork.
Okay.
So we're currently a quarter mile away from it. Very within sight.
Yes. The windmill's stone walls are, well, that's easily climbed. That's not relevant right now, anyway. The old Svalik Road transitions here from being a winding path to the Balinok Mountains to a lazy trail that hugs the mountainside as it descends into a fog-filled valley. In the heart of the valley, you see a walled town near the shores of a great mountain lake. That's over there, I guess. That's Valak. That's a Valaki. Its waters dark and still. A branch in the road leads west to a promontory, atop which is perched a dilapidated stone windmill. Its warped wooden vanes stripped bare.
No, weren't we told about some windmill around this?
I don't remember anything of windmill.
And we're walking.
You sure?
And we are moving right along from that creepy place.
Are you sure?
You really don't want to check it out?
Yeah, we're sure.
One, two, three, four.
I was waiting for the third going. Third time the charm. That's what we needed. Right.
So there's as you kind of pass through or like cross the road right there, there is an old. Let's see here. Hang on.
So you pick great music for this. Like this has to play for like always now. Anytime we're outside in this place, yeah. this is playing.
There's an old lady. Ooh. You see, walking down the path, and she has a cart.
Is she Vivana?
She's not of the Vistani that you know of. Like, she's not really wearing super vibrant clothes or anything. She's kind of tattered, like rags, and on her on the wagon she has a pretty good smelling like pastries. Let's see.
I kind of want to ask her what she's selling.
I think it's pretty obvious.
Children pies. It's okay.
What? Got him.
These are
some might say cherry pies.
These are excellent mincemeat pies.
Children.
I make them myself. Would you like one?
Belena accepts the pie.
So does Nagri.
No, Nagri. He
actually, you know, Phil would probably do that.
Nagri is not cool with the mincemeat pies.
Blaine wants to give one a shot. She don't care. She ain't afraid.
Hang on.
She hungry.
Is that a good angle?
Yeah, that's a good angle. I'm really liking the camera angle on the maps and everything. It's rad. So she hang on. Yeah. She looks like this. That's actually kind of interesting. We have a picture.
Oh. Blaine will try, huh?
Hey you, Evander. This is the mincemeat pie lady.
Okay.
Mincemeat, by the way, is a type of fruit pie, I believe.
What?
Yeah. Mincemeat. It's like a... It's not actually meat. It's a fruit.
Oh.
I don't believe
it. Fruit type of pie. It really is.
What? What? This doesn't make any sense.
Wait. Hold on.
Have you never heard of mincemeat?
I gotta use this.
Alright.
Well, there's meat pies. And then there's one people... Legend has it they would run a barber shop and slit people's throats
and then
make them meat pies.
Mrs. Lovett.
What the fuck did they call it minced meat?
What a charming notion, eminently practical.
That's really good. I kind of see it live. Mad I didn't see it.
Okay, so I need. Well, if Blaine's going to eat a pie, it is very tasty.
Fruit and meat.
And I need her to make a constitution saving throw, please.
Which one are you going to use? Nice.
Natural 20. Very nice.
Drop a bunch of these tonight.
See, we were rolling awful in Artan as soon as we got here.
This
we
is the best place we've ever been to.
We're never leaving. We're gonna go kick Strahd straight and in the dick, throw him out of the castle, rename it Castle Yol Castle.
Yol Castle.
Yes.
Castle Yol Castle.
Castle Yol Castle.
Yol Castle.
I love
That's
it.
Castle Yol Castle.
Castle Yol Castle. Okay. I got it.
I'm ready for this. Inch has never been more ready for anything in his life.
We'll have two freaking castles now.
Okay.
Castle Yol Castle and...
I need everyone to make perception checks, please. Or no, wait.
Oh, good. All right, yep.
What's your... Well, okay, what is it?
What was that?
18?
Nice, okay.
The opposite of natural 20.
Okay.
We got a 1 for Imsh and a 21 for Belena.
Very nice.
I just stabbed him, his eyes out.
I just didn't see like, him.
My eyes out. Let's see.
Totally did too. I drank one of those death dancer drinks. Like, I fucked up.
Natural 1.
Yeah, okay. Well,
three of you rolled 1.
Was that 20?
You jinxed us.
22.
We're doing awesome.
For perception, you
said? I've rolled 4 ones tonight. That's bad.
You're the only one that sees this.
I need to go to the casino.
Blaney got 21.
There's no way I can roll 4 ones tonight.
Damn.
For 3 hours.
So,
casino
on her wagon.
Blaney got a what?
21.
Dang.
Yeah, I want to go to the casino.
So, the way that her wagon is set up, like on the top, there's the Nismi mine.
Because I know I will.
And then, underneath, there's like cloth.
No, I know.
Kind of surrounding the like underside of the wagon,
nope.
And you see
it's
just, and you roll really, really high. So you're the only one that sees it. But there's like a slight rustling, a movement under, like from within the wagon, like cloth.
Wait, so how big is this cart thing?
It's she pushes it, so it's like it's probably about the size of half of this table.
Okay. And
was the mincemeat tasty?
Pretty deep.
Yes, she did enjoy it. She felt a little weird, but, nothing really happened.
It's a poor lamb, strange food will do that to you.
Nothing messes with the monks. They have excellent digestive systems.
Well, that's fermented food they have to eat all the time.
Yeah.
That woman looks awful. I'm never accepting pie.
You respond to this cloth?
I'm like, no.
Ma'am, what is in your cart? What else do you have in there?
Just mince pies.
Then why is it moving?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Done.
So I casually place my hands like over the hilts of my scimitars.
Boom. Uh huh.
Would you mind showing us what you have underneath your pies?
No. No, I would not.
Well, that's something dirty.
Well, what do you have to hide if you only have more pies, ma'am?
Oh dear, he's reaching for the monster manual.
And out right, from the
so
treasure
I am ready.
I'm sure you are.
I am.
I gotta look some shit up. So
I am.
Bear with me a moment.
Let's be ready to hack and slash everything.
Everything.
It's my dinner.
And what's on the menu?
Catchphrase.
Oh, that's good.
Hmm. That's my little secret.
Well, thank you for your time. Have a good one. Take it easy now.
At that
point, hell of a pie.
At that point, you hear
a rustle,
kind of like a murmur coming from underneath the wagon. And give me an insight.
Yes.
An insight check.
Yes.
Get some side.
God, it's like four ones in a row we've rolled.
Everyone hears it because it's like eerily quiet here. So give me an insight from everybody.
Seven. Not a one. I thought it was a one.
Got a four for Imsh.
I got a four for me. I'll roll for Nagri.
I'm focusing too hard on the woman.
14.
Oh, for Nagri. I roll for Nagri.
Alright.
18. Much more insight. Better.
Nine for Boy. No.
18 for Nagri. He has no insight.
Okay, so you recognize the sound. And it's the sound of a small child.
Well, I told you, motherfuckers.
Alright, I had my guard up.
Literally, I'm ready for just shit saying that right now.
Imch would like a mincemeat pie.
yeah. I'm just gonna eat a mincemeat pie.
After hearing the sound of a child, yes.
Well,
oh wait, you're making those with babies? Give me two, woman. Yeah. Why are you being weird?
Imch totally wants to eat one. Do all right. Constitution for that?
You yes, guys, you will. Give me Constitution saving throw, please.
You guys thought I was lying about them eating children here. This 20. Whole time, you thought I was making 20. That up. 20 and look at this old ass hag eating children.
What did Elena roll last time?
Nat 20.
Nat 20. Yeah. Okay.
Plus two.
all right. Hang on.
I'm just going to keep bitching about how I told you guys they were eating children. I knew it. I knew it.
I knew it.
Man, it's all about eating children.
Okay, that's not too bad.
Are we under-leveled for this? Because we're rolling like 20s and 21s and we're not...
Oh, you guys are actually way over-leveled for this.
We're not perceiving shit. Let's fail a constitution save with a 20.
So you start having these really surreal dreams of being in a joyous place.
I'm tripping balls right now.
Far removed from the evils of the world.
All right.
The places and characters in the dream are vivid and believable.
Because you need these kids.
And when the dream ends, you will experience a longing to return to the place. And that will last for 5 hours. And during which time you are incapacitated and your speed is zero.
Someone grabs one of those pies.
So you just just zonked out for 5 hours.
I could have given you that with a death dancer.
Seriously,
you fuck.
People keep grabbing more pies. I want to trip balls later.
I need like six of them.
Okay, so here's, do I have a pen? Here's what happens. You hear. Like, you all kind of hear the murmur. Several of you figure out that it's a small child of some kind. And Imch...
eats a pie anyway.
Eats a pie. He didn't really catch on to what it was.
No, he, I knew.
And,
just wanted to eat children.
Eats a pie anyway. And is just, like, catatonic. He eats it and his arms drop to his side. Attack. And he has this big, doofy smile on his face. And he just is like off in crazy land, you know?
I feel like you guys should eat some of these pies. It's your balls with me.
No, even Eisenschmidt is like...
scissor to her, like... hold, like
he's gonna automatically
like,
murder
hold,
her?
Like, no, hold her there, like...
Even Eisenschmidt's like, I can't even deal with that stuff. Like, you know?
I wish I had a chance before
set up the,
to tell
the,
you guys to get more scissors. Pies.
Yeah.
Just like hold him out. What are you?
And I'm actually
doing?
Going to move move toward. I want to move towards the cart and peek underneath the
Oh, you just go, okay. I got it.
After, make sure.
After I...
After you, yeah. You set her up.
I want to make sure that that's okay. Going on.
We'll get to what happens there in the next part.
Later!
God damn it. It's one...